Howdy, howdy, and welcome back to Gale FFTCG. I'm Corbin, and today we're going to be taking a look, by special request of the great British video gamer, a player I've had the pleasure of facing off with a number of times, very good player. They requested that I build a deck based around this guy, 4CP Dorgan. Dawn Warrior, Category 5, that is relevant at some point, and we'll go into that in a minute. 8k, win forward. When a backup enters your field, you choose one forward opponent controls, remove it from the game, as long as Dorgan is on the field. So this seems like a really cool card, and I was actually really excited to build around this card, because while it doesn't appear to me immediately good, and at the time when it came out, it kind of was just thrown to the side as a really dead, useless card. Wasn't worth anything. The advent of a couple of new cards has actually been really helpful to building this deck up. So, yeah, without further ado, let's get into it. Our strategy is we're playing a heavy control game. We want to get Dorgan as soon as possible. We're only running two copies, but we have loads of ways of getting him. That's not a problem. We want to get Dorgan down early and be playing our backups as fast as we can. We need to protect Dorgan, so we're running things like Ystola and Kukulin and just things like Aerith and all that sort of stuff, just to make sure that our Dorgan survives and so our opponents can't get back any of their forwards. And we want to break or loop our own backups to remove forwards. That was something that previous versions of this deck didn't have. This list has that, and we can loop and break a lot of our stuff. So, going on to synergy, there is a whole lot of synergy in this deck, mostly because when Dorgan is on the field, we want him to be as effective as possible, so we need a lot of synergies to get Dorgan to that place where he's effective on his own, but we also have a backup plan in case that all fails. So, first, we have Sarah, so we can search up Ovelia's. We're running the 3CP1 over the 2CP1, but that's about all we need to know for that particular card. It's just a backup that searches another backup, which is always great. We have Norshtalin, which again searches other backups. This one, however, is very important. We are searching Althea. That is the only target we've got with Norshtalin, but it's still our best target. If we can get this down early, we'll be getting Althea, and that's how we win the game. We have one copy of Shinra, which searches for a Job Gull Wings. So this can be either 2CP Riku or the 3CP Pain to search the Riku if we really want to get two backups on a turn. If we have Dorgan down, so much the better. So Althea, I said, is one of the most important cards of this list, and that holds 100% true. It's a 3CP Princess, so you can also search it off of Sarah, which is interesting to note. FFCC, so we can search off Norshtalin. When it enters the field, we choose a character other than Althea we control. We activate it. We can tap and choose another character other than Althea that we control. We return it and Althea to its owner's hand. So basically, we can loop our backups and start going off with Dorgan. One of, honestly, the most important cards in the deck. We are running one copy of Mog FFBE. So we can search up Cid FFBE or Mid. Mid is protection, and Cid FFBE, there's a fun little combo that I'll go into detail in a little bit. We are running one Simon, because he's a breakable backup, which is always good, but we can also get back copies of Ovelia and stuff like that, so that's pretty cool. We're running one copy of Riku to activate all of our forwards. Honestly, this is just a searchable backup. There are very few times that this will actually have any other relevant bearing to the game, but it's still important to know that they're there. We have three copies of Syldra. This is a 4CP that searches for two water characters, two category 5 characters, or one of each with a different cost and add them to our hand. So what we do is we can go ahead with any water character. So we choose Dorgan because he's a category 5, and then we can choose any other water character that we like, backups or forwards. Really versatile card, but it's almost always going to be searching Dorgan in this list. Now, bringing back a very old engine, this is that sort of list, we have a Seador, who is a Job Prince forward, so Sarah can search him. which is kind of cool. Category 4, so not searchable off of Syldra for the Category 5 thing, but doesn't matter. It's a water character anyway. You can dole one active card named Cecil forward and one active card named Rosa forward, both of which we play, to play Cyodor onto the field. 4 CP, 8K. Cyodor is just a free forward, and that's really good. We are kind of... because if our Dorgan backup plan fails, we do want to have some bodies on the field. Cyodor is just a good free body in this case. Up next, we have one Titus. And Titus buffs all the Category 10 forwards we control by 1,000 power. That doesn't matter. We have a pain. That's 3K, so it's not going to change anything. However, its ability that when it enters the field, it bounces a backup to its hand, and then we choose an opponent's forward or a forward and bounce it to hand. We can choose our own or our opponent's. That's pretty cool. We're only running one of it, so we can't make use of its special. 4 CP, 8K. Being able to bounce a backup just means we have more ammo to get Dorgan going, basically. We're running 3 of the 4 CP Cecil. If you control 2 or more Category 4 forwards other than Cecil, Cecil gains plus 2K and Brave. So basically, if you have Rosa and Cyodor, he becomes a 10K. We can also choose a forward we control other than Cecil during this turn. The next time that forward would take damage, it is reduced by 4,000 instead and deal 4,000 to Cecil. So you can only use that once per turn, but it doesn't really matter. It's extra protection for Dorgan. We can throw some onto Cecil. Cecil will be able to tank it, no problem. And because of our next card, it can even reduce that further. So this Rosa searches for a card named Cecil, which is awesome. So we'll be searching for the 4 CP one, obviously. Sorry about that. We can tap and choose a forward, and during this turn, the next damage dealt to it is reduced by 1,000 instead. If that's Cecil, it's reduced by 3,000. So we have this card is great for a number of reasons. We can search Cecil, so effectively draw a card. And on top of that, we can reduce damage for our Dorgan or our Cecil. Really good stuff. Up next, we have 3 CP Pain. And this is the last one in our synergy slot. It literally searches for a Riku, and that's it. Was originally thinking about maybe a Yuna, but Yuna's not necessarily relevant in this particular type of list. Up next, we've got our card advantage. And in our card advantage, we really only have two cards here. This deck, obviously, synergy crosses over quite a bit with card advantage. But in this case, the synergy is far... there's nothing in here specifically for card advantage. There's a lot more in here to make sure Dorgan's engine gets going. So, we have one Alchemist. 2 CP, we can crack it and put it... and then go ahead, discard a card from our hand, and search for one card of the same card type. So that can be anything. That could be backups. Maybe we search Althea off of it. There's loads of different ways we can make it work. So that's all, that's quite fun. Not much more to say here. It's a searcher. Breakable backup. There you go. Ash, 2 CP, is awesome. It's also a princess, so we can search it off of Sarah. There's a lot more princesses than I realized at first. If you control 6 or more characters, Ash gains plus 2k, and Ash can't be chosen by your opponent's abilities. And at the end of each of your turns, if you've cast 3 or more cards this turn, draw a card. So it can be a 7k that can't be targeted. And then if you cast 3 or more cards this turn, draw a card. So ideally, you want this down early. You start playing a lot of backups. We have quite a few cheap ones in this list. Or you go ahead with Dorgan, and you're just like, okay, I'm going to go ahead and start looping my backups and do a thing with that. So that's fun. Up in our removal slots, there's not a lot here either. However, there is some fun little combos and a bit of card draw here as well. Chiefest currently in the removal slot, at least in my opinion, and I know a few other people share this one as well, Agrius. 5 CP, EX Burst, Job Knight. When Agrius enters the field, you can, if you control a princess, you draw a card. When Agrius enters the field, choose a forward opponent controls, and if you control Avelia, you reduce something by 7k, and then damage 5, you can search for a category FFT forward and add it to your hand. So you could add Agrius in your hand if you liked. But that is the only one that we really have. So we have Sid FFBE. We're only running this as a one-of because we can search it off of Mog, but there was, I think this was Winter Cup, Cardiff, I want to say 2 or 3 years ago now, and I saw somebody playing Dorgan, and they'd removed all their stuff, but then played Sid FFBE. I'm not saying this combo is like broken by any stretch, but it's a cool combo. If Dorgan dies, all those cards come back, and Sid FFBE sees them entering without having paid the CP cost. It deals 9k to those things, which is really cool. So, yeah, just a funny little combo. I thought I would put it in more as almost an ode to the combo rather than making it the main thing of the deck. We don't want Dorgan just dying for the sake of dying. We want to keep him alive as long as we can. And finally, in our removal slot, we have Cagnazzo. He's an Archfiend, 2 CP, 4k. When a forward other than Cag enters the field, we put a water counter on Cagnazzo. We remove 3 to choose a forward, reduce it by 8k. Remove 7 from Cagnazzo for a 10k board wipe on all of our opponent's forwards. So that's a lot of fun. I do like that. In our protection slots, we have quite a few things, simply because, obviously, we need to protect Dorgan. So first off, we have Ovelia. Ovelia is a princess. Again, we can search it, all that sort of fun jazz. When a category FFT forward you control is put from the field into the break zone, we get to draw a card once per turn. So we only have Agrius, but that could be relevant. We also have Aegis, so we can discard a copy of her, tap, choose one forward we control, and until end of turn, it gains haste, and when it's put from the field into the break zone, we can play that forward and back to the field without paying, or just put it dull, and we don't have to pay for it. So that's a cool thing. That can protect our Dorgans, bring back Ovelia, all sorts of really fun stuff. We are running 2 of the 2 CP summoner. We just put it in the break zone. Choose a summon of cost 3 or less, cancel its effect. Really simple stuff, but highly effective, especially with Amaterasu running around. An Amaterasu can easily kill our Dorgan, and we really don't want that. Now, for arguably one of the best cards in the deck, slash one of the most powerful cards in the game currently, just for what it does. 1 CP, Kukulain the Impure. So, it's an EX burst, and we choose a forward, it loses all abilities till end of turn, draw a card. So this seems decent. If you've watched any of the Lightning Water decks that have been running around recently, they have been negating their own Lightning. And so I wondered if that was the case with Dorgan after checking with a couple of people. That is the case. You can blank Dorgan. So say your opponent wants to go, oh no, you've removed like 4 of my guys. I want to blow up Dorgan now and get them all back. You just go Kukulain the Impure and his ability is gone. So what happens is when Dorgan dies, those cards do not return to the field. They are removed from game permanently, and you lose a Dorgan, but they don't get anything back. And you get to draw a card off of that, so it nets you some CP as well. Just a fantastic card, and that combo is will really take your opponents by surprise. We have 1 copy of Mid. Mid has back attack, and when it enters the field, choose a forward other than Mid. Until end of turn, it gains plus 1k and cannot be chosen by your opponent's abilities. Decent card. It is FFBE, so we can search it. I do like that. We have 1 Aerith of the 3 CP variety. If a forward you control is dealt damage less than its power, the damage becomes 0 instead. If Aerith is dealt damage by a summoner ability, reduce the damage by 2000 instead. When Aerith is put from the field into the break zone, activate all the backups you control. Honestly, this is just a way of reducing damage, and if we are able to reactivate our backups, we can respond with Kukulains and all that sort of stuff. So, not too bad. And we're running 2 copies of Ystola. Ystola, if it's dealt damage by a summoner ability, the damage becomes zero. And we put Ystola into the break zone, and she uses one summon or auto ability, we can cancel the effect. Just great. Good ways of stopping our opponent from removing Dorgan. Just a fantastic card. But yeah, we are coming to the end of the video. Let me know what you think. Shout out to the Great British Video Gamer for suggesting Dorgan as a card focus in Spotlight. I hope you all enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and hit that bell notification for any upcoming videos. And yeah, also don't forget there is a really fun spoiler video that I released on Friday, and I'm really excited for that. That is the Kefka spoiler. And yeah, I hope you guys have a great Sunday and a great rest of your week.